What is going on, guys? We are back. If you didn't check out last night's video, we did the update on the full mods rundown that we did to this car, the C5. If you don't know me, I'm Senate Steve. That's my C5 Corvette, and we will be taking it to the YouTube call out. So I wanted to do a little bit of an update. You know, a bunch of people have asked me about this truck. I did end up selling it. The customer took it for inspection, and it needed ball joints, which I did not know about. I checked it out, but I guess, you know, either I did something wrong or I don't know. You know, I'm one to admit when I mess up. So I don't really know what happened or what the issue was, but it needs ball joints and I'm gonna take care of it today for the customer. So I believe it only needed the uppers, but we are actually gonna do all four because he plans on towing a little travel trailer because he goes camping as well. So I told him, you know, hey, you know, we'll just do it all while we're there. It's easy to do. Plus it takes, you know, maybe a half an hour extra per side, if that. So let's go ahead and get that done. The other thing is we now have a power steering leak. Hold on, let me get down here so you don't hear the wind noise. So lately with the F-250 power stroke, we are having a power steering leak of some sort. I didn't get to check that out, but I want to do the ball joints first, and then we will actually check this truck out. It has just been sitting here. I haven't driven it. Everything, as you can see, is soaked underneath here. And the reason I noticed it is because I happened to look in this wheel liner and you can see how soaking wet it is. Now, there's where you can really tell the difference. So I noticed something was spraying, and I also then the following day started to hear a little bit of a whine. So if you don't know, this truck was hit by a PennDOT truck. I'm not saying it was from the incident, but you know, it's something that we're gonna have to get addressed because in 3 weeks we are actually going camping. So we're gonna get that truck addressed, but first let's head over and do the F-150. This was a car I did purchase. It's a 2008 Scion, 150,000 miles. This is actually the car that I took to Montoursville to Vet Villains and pick up the rest of the parts for the Corvette, which I believe are actually still in the passenger seat because it's been crazy here. I've been really, really busy, guys. I know you guys like when I work on car videos and things like that and you ask for them, but I just, you know, it's kind of hard to record, hold a camera, take out bolts and do things like that. Plus, I don't know how to do the time-lapse thing yet. So we do have the cooling fans for the C5. Thank you again to Brian at Vet Villains and Justin at Vet Villains. So we are gonna get this installed too because we are going to the dyno. So let me go ahead and get this thing started. I want to get this thing up on jack stands, get the wheels off, and then we'll throw the cooling fans in this car, and we're ready for the dyno tomorrow. What are you doing? You're a stinker. You out here enjoying the nice weather? Yeah. All right, so we got the upper control arm on here. As you can see, brand new everything. I always recommend ones with the fittings in so you can actually grease them yourself. If it doesn't have a fitting and they say they're you know, no grease or non-greasable or whatever, I don't recommend those. I definitely recommend ones that you can grease because they just live longer. Plus then you can control, you know, when you grease them and things like that versus a non-greasable one, you know, once the grease is dry or once the boot splits, you know, you're just kind of SOL. So are you gonna jump down? So we did do the lower one also. Not sure how well you can see it there. Right there, that one also has a greasable fitting. And that's why we opted for these ones because I always love ones that are greasable. They just last longer. Plus, like I said, you can maintain them and you can do them whenever you want. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the wheel back on here. Yeah, and we have a truck down there too. Yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the wheel back on, get the jack stands and everything out from under here, and we're gonna start the other side. You got it, dude.
You got it, dude. How rude.
How rude. All right, we'll start the other side, guys. Okay, guys, I'll just briefly show you. This is actually a clip that it goes on here. You just break it free here. I usually just use a flathead screwdriver. And then it's very simple to do the upper control arm slash ball joint on these. It's just this bolt here, which is a 21 millimeter or 7/8. This bolt here, 21 or 7/8, you back them out. There's one on this side. Back them out, this arm comes off, and take the cotter pin loose there, and that bolt there. I'll just do that real quick and then show you. All right, so that is actually the passenger side one. This is the driver's side. You can see how much thicker the aftermarket one is by Detroit Axle. And those are the ones I recommend to anybody. You can get them online or you can get them in store, but you just have to ask by them by name. Now, Moog is also another good name brand, but for this application, we're just doing a Detroit arm. So you can tell these bushings are beat on here. They're just bad new bushings. So let's get it back together. Now for the lower ball joint, it's pretty simple. I always recommend getting the hub out of the way. I usually tuck it right behind the upper control arm here. As you can see, I already have the new one on. I usually just tuck it right in here and it can't go anywhere. It wouldn't hurt to put a strap or something around it. But for the lower one, just grab a hammer and start swinging away. Now you guys get a little idea why I can't really record. I'm literally just using one hand and smacking away. But there you have it. Ball joint's out, grab the new one. Now with the new one, I will use a press to press it up on, and I don't know how I'm gonna record that, but I'll try. All right guys, so we got it all buttoned up here and got the new ball joint in. New ball joint in on this side also. Got the Zerk fitting. Turn fitting, we're good to go. So I'm gonna throw the wheel on it here and we're gonna tell the customer that he should take it for an alignment. I know everything sort of falls in place. The uppers on these have like key locks. So, you know, unless you don't put that key lock back in, you should, you know, you definitely need an alignment. But with this having a key lock in place, you don't really have to take it for an alignment. How's your snack? Good. All right, so let me go ahead and get the wheel and everything back on, get the jack stands out of here, jack out of here, and we're gonna take it and get it finished off with the inspection. All right guys, so today was actually a very productive day. As you can tell, that truck is out of my yard, out of my hair, long gone. Now, like I said, I did do the ball joints, I did clean them up already, but for the last hour, I've been dialing in the C5. Now, I was having problems with the intake air temp sensor, and I put a new one in it. I was still getting negative readings. So I actually ended up finding the issue. It had a broken wire. So I've been wiring that, getting that all figured out. So that car is 100% ready to hit the dyno tomorrow. I couldn't be any more excited about that. Also, I do want to touch base on the 6.0. I did found the power steering leak. So I ran to Advanced Auto and they actually had the line in stock. So we picked this up. I didn't get a chance to fix that today. Like I said, I was actually trying to get this car, you know, so that it was 100% ready for the dyno tomorrow. So hope you guys are excited. Tomorrow you will have an upload of the car on the dyno. With that being said, guys, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe, hit that like button, and I'll see you guys on the dyno tomorrow. Keith's Pit Stop, Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, 10 a.m. Guys, I hope you are too. It's finally coming together. We are almost ready for the call out. April 29th, Cecil County Dragway.